down, slugger. Why at Kauai, we ain't never got ourselves made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why at Kauai, we ain't never got ourselves made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter.
Show, just so you know, we just wanna get lit, any, many, miny, mo. For show, just so you know, we just wanna get lit, any, many, miny, mo. All this money.
Madden Football is the home of and this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Packers and the Titans, and it's coming up next.
It's the next EA Sports. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Tennessee Titans taking on the NFC champions, the Green Bay Packers. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thrilled to be with you guys. And, well, you think that they're having fun on Broadway in downtown Nashville right about now? Yeah, just a touch. And what a year the Titans have put together as they search for their first title in franchise history.
And remember, they've only been to the Super Bowl one time before, but now that they're back, I think they can set aside the agony of that appearance. That was back in 2000. They played the Rams. Remember Kevin Dyson catching the pass late in the game, stretching for the goal line and not quite getting there? And that was also the same year of the Music City Miracle. Yep. When they got to the, you know, won in the playoffs against Buffalo, got to the Super Bowl, but now they're back. Set it all to the side. Set it all in the past. Here come the Titans trying to win it all.
Meanwhile, the Packers are back as they look to bring another Super Bowl title home to a place aptly named Title Town.
And they're looking for their fifth win, which would tie them with the Cowboys and 49ers for second all time. They did last win it in 2011 out of Super Bowl 45. Aaron Rodgers leading them over the Pittsburgh Steelers. But when you talk about titles, and you mentioned Title Town, they've won 13 championships overall when you count all the NFL titles prior to the Super Bowl era as well. So this is a town that's used to winning, and they expect to win this one as well.
Now it's second and nine. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. Call it a gain of five that time, and they'll be left with a third and about four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Brings up third and four.
Rodgers now to throw. This one swung out here to Jones. And he is going to have a Packers first down. They needed four. He doubled that. He wound up getting eight.
Nice methodical opening drive here. They're already in the field goal range. They're in a good spot. You know that people like to take a shot in this part of the field. But at the same time, as methodical as they've been, they might want to run the ball a little bit here, too.
And just on the outskirts of the red zone, they have options now. Either way, though, they've come out with a purpose.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left them no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second and nine, Rodgers. That's going to be caught. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
First and goal.
A chance for the first score of this Super Bowl. Here's first and goal. Jones. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. With a first touchdown of this Super Bowl and a long one at that. And the Packers are on the board first here in this Super Bowl. Crosby connects on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. And nothing doing on his first run. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it.
This Super Bowl, of course, just a huge one for this head coach. The first time he's walked the sidelines in a game of this magnitude. And you know, I might normally ask the cliche, what's going through his mind right now? But
and a big loss here as he's taken down. Kenny Clark able to get in there and run him down for what's going to be a loss of 15 yards all told. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going deep for Brown. He's got a man complete. 30, the 20. Touchdown, Titans.
Boy, A.J. Brown, one of the best in the NFL with the ball in his hands, and there's another example why.
Extra point up and good by Bullock.
And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away.
On the return from his end zone, Malik Taylor.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Second and six.
They fake the give. Now Rodgers looking deep for Adams. And that's caught inside the 35. And it's a Packers touchdown.
I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play. And that was something special there. Boy, was he moving.
Well, this is the right routes, blocking assignments, misdirections and stuff. They have these precise arrows and movements. Sometimes the best plays just come from the schoolyard where you look at your fastest guy and say, go long, go get it, big man.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and take it. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. A run there on first down and a pretty good one of 5 yards, so make it second and 5. Ball on the 30, they'll come up with a second and 5. Here's Hurts to throw. He'll buy some time right. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Eluding the pressure right. He's going deep for Brown. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown. And that looked almost to be a case of, you know, a quarterback saying, hey, I'm going to throw this as far as I can and hope you run under it. Mission accomplished.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield. And, you know, everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. On the return from his end zone, Malik Taylor. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on first and 10. Throwing is Rodgers. A throw complete to the tight end, Tonyan. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh, boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Second down, another shot for Jones.
Oh, that's the way to
9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. 17 yards on the play there as the Packers have the first down as well. Clock runs, less than a minute to go, and an entertaining first quarter of play. Now they'll throw with Rodgers. Caught by Jones. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's third and inches. Here's Rodgers to throw. Got a man. It's Tonyan. And the Packers are going to be set up with a first and goal as they get the conversion there on third and inches. The Packers with the football here to begin the second quarter. They scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. Now Jones. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Packers have moved out in front. Crosby with the extra point, and the lead is now 21-14. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Cameron Batson now from his end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They'll look for a drive to tie this up, down 21-14 as they have it first and 10. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. It'll be a gain of 6, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 4 at the 27-yard line.
Throwing is Hurts. This will go to Henry out wide. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
On second down now, it's Henry. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2.
Hurts
flushed out right, and Hurts able to show off some of that elusiveness as he slides to the ground there, and in the process picks up the first down. Hurts dangerous when he runs that football. He's got a first. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's 1st and 10 up at the 46. Now a throw here to his running back, and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down. Running left, it's Henry. And he'll bring this one inside the 35. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and a yard.
Hurts with a little pop pass on the jet sweep. First down and much more for Henry. And he's going to get it all the way down to the 10-yard line. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. So not quite a first and goal. It's 1st and 10 from the 10. Now a handoff to Henry. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. Big Kenny Clark that time pushing upfield to make the tackle for loss. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's 2nd and 12. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. A check down here for Henry. And he will score! Touchdown, Titans! Derrick Henry! A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying up this Super Bowl. Bullet good on the extra point. And we are tied here in the second quarter. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21-all the score as the kick's away. On the return from his end zone, Malik Taylor. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. His goal, and it'll be good for a first down.
First down to the 40-yard line.
On play action, it's Rodgers. Man open, that's Marquez Valdez-Scantling. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. He was a 1,000-yard receiver during the regular season, and that's his first catch of the Super Bowl, and he picks up the first down. To throw is Rodgers. That's complete to Cobb. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
This has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Wide open receiver complete. And he's brought down after a very nice gain.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
They'll try and run it in with Jones. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. One back in the game, that's Jones, second and goal. And it's a Packers touchdown. Randall Cobb. Fine work there on the touchdown run. And the Packers have moved out in front. These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today is track shoes. That's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far, and fun to watch. The Titans offense set to begin the drive as they take over with exactly 1 minute to go. Flush to his right. Oh, and Hurts is going to be hit and taken down to the ground.
So this has been a lot like a tennis match, hasn't it? Back and forth. Both these offenses happened their way so far. So maybe the question isn't who's going to score the most points in this game. Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack finally. He rifles one. It's intercepted. Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks him. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. What a moment for him. A pick six in the Super Bowl. You think about some of the big pick sixes over the history of this huge game. I remember because I was watching with a lot of Colts fans, Tracy Porter picking Peyton Manning to get the Saints' first title.
Yeah, that would pretty much seal the deal for New Orleans as well. But I got to go back a ways because, you know, unfortunately, I'm considerably older. Herb Adderley, the Green Bay Packers, got it all started. The first pick six, Super Bowl II against the Oakland Raiders, and some of the better ones that were out there. You might remember Dwight Smith of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers had 2-1 game when they won their Super Bowl championship against Rich Gannon in Oakland. You mentioned Tracy Porter already. How about James Harrison of the Steelers? You remember that one? 100 yards right before the half ended? That was a big-time play. But for me,
trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 32. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see.
First and goal at the 4-yard line.
Rodgers going to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro linebacker. It's Von Miller. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. So these two teams will head to the locker room as we hit halftime in Super Bowl 56. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. This taken in at the goal line. And good coverage there on special teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And right now, their chances of hoisting that Lombardi trophy not looking too great, but perhaps that long halftime, maybe it did them a world of good.
But if there's ever a chance to regroup, it's in this game, right? Because you do have that long halftime, a chance to really assess things and maybe make some changes and true adjustments. They've played great all year long. That was the worst first half of the season.
And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Tyler Lancaster able to run him down for a loss of a yard. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Play action. Here's Hurts. This is caught. It's Brown. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A very solid gain of 27.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep at the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
And they'll get this just to the 47, 1 yard gain.
Nice job there defensively. A great time to dial up a blitz.
And give him credit under center instead of throwing it away. Actually, a pretty good job of getting past the line of scrimmage, not losing yardage. Being chased out left. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
A gain of 13 yards. That's good for a Tennessee Titan.
They go play action with Hurts. Buying time to his left. And he wisely will throw that one away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. And he's got the hook up to Moore. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And Henry fighting for the marker, but I don't think he got there. He did not. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. From the gun, it's Hurts. Rolling to his right. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Jalen Hurts taking it in from the 20. And the Titans are able to make this a close game again. Extra point up and good by Bullock. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. On the return from his end zone, Malik Taylor. Taylor decides not to try to return it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
So operating from Tennessee territory now, here's first and 10 at the 46. Here's Rodgers. This one complete to Tonyan underneath. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. On second down, it's Jones. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 7.
The give is to Jones.
And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Caught on the right side by Adams. And they got it inside the 10 at the 8. His second catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Now Rodgers. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked by Kevin Byard. And he'll bring it all the way back, just a yard or two shy of midfield. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find...
Oh, and hurt. Taken down to the ground. Za'Darius Smith. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop it. We've seen situations earlier in the game and get away for pretty good yardage. At that time, they get him down.
Yeah, they've had enough evidence that he can get away and run for good yardage, haven't they?
Under pressure, they got him again. Chris Jones, he's the one that drops him this go-around. And that pass rush getting strong here. Back-to-back sacks. The play-action fake. They'll look to throw. That ball nearly intercepted, but he could not hang on. Oh, a pick there certainly would have been nice. Instead, at least, it'll be fourth down. On is Kern, the punter, to send this one away. And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. Yeah, that's a 48-yard punt with the coverage holding him to 3 on the return. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only...
That's caught inside the 20. And he'll take this all the way down to the 15-yard line.
We see this happen so often. If you're a defender, it's like watching a bad movie over and over. The pressure's good, forcing the quarterback out of the pocket. But it's a lot to ask for these defenders to stay plastered to receivers long enough. And sure enough, they let a man come open, and the connection leads to a big play.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Rodgers tapping this forward on the jet sweep. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. From the shotgun to give to Jones. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Only a yard that time, second and goal.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Jones again. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
And this will result in him losing yardage back to the three. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter.
A 20-yard attempt.
And Crosby puts it through, and that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So that's, CD, an important one here in the fourth quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a two-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a two-score game, and they were able to get it done.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And we're at the time in this Super Bowl where, look, they need points. And they need them badly. Trailing here in the fourth quarter as they begin this drive first and 10. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit.
First and 10 at the 30.
A first down carry for Henry. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 40 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 41. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And that nearly a turnover, but it's incomplete. Oh, fortunate to retain possession there, and it's second down.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
He dumps it off for Henry. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 19. A good pickup there, a 22. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. This will be caught by Brown. 3 yards the gain there, second down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Yeah, the Titans are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
That's good.
Henry. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Derrick Henry. His second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Titans have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Bullock good on the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. On the return from his end zone, Malik Taylor. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And the tension ratcheting up all around. A one-score game, fourth quarter of the Super Bowl. This is what you folks came for. Every play with the potential to win or lose a title as they look to drain some time off this clock. Bud Dupree, a former first-round pick, in on the stop. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. They'll go again to Jones. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Brings up the 3rd down.
The battle in the trenches never more important than right now. This is 3rd and inches. Rodgers now to throw.
He's got his man, Valdez-Scantling. And he is going to have a Packers first down, as that'll be a pickup of about five as they convert on third and inches. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down, went his way, and worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Play action, Rodgers. And this is going to be incomplete. How good has he been throwing the football, though? And despite that incompletion, that's just the third time he's been off target this entire game.
And Brandon, I've been on the other side of this equation, trying to defend a guy who's been this hot, and it chips away at your confidence. And when you're not confident when you're trying to defend, it makes you slower to the football and it leads to more completions for them.
They'll try and run some clock now with Jones. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. 76 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Rodgers going to try and throw on third down. Man open, here is Jones.
This is too easy right here. Too easy.
Touchdown, Packers. Aaron Jones with his third touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Packers are starting to pull away in the fourth quarter of this Super Bowl. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who's a complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
Cameron Batson now from his end zone. Batson not going to risk returning it, so they'll start at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tab.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On the move to his left. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call a flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. Steps away to his left. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Escaping the pressure right. And right side, Henry's got it. And he will have a Titans first down, and he was able to get it by plenty. A gain of 8 on 3rd and 3. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, no, he lost the football. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. can almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of three, but now it's third down.
It's a gain of three.
Hurts. Flushed out right. This is caught. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Throwing is Hurts. Flush to his right. And he's got it. Touchdown. Oh, but there is a marker on the field. So now the question, who is this on? Now Bullock to add the extra point. And the lead is down to a field goal now.
Makes the score, Packers 45, Titans.
So with under 30 seconds to play, this is the game right here. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
First and 10 at the 16-yard line.
This is Jones. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
On second down, it's Jones. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. And a timeout coming in. This will be their final one with 10 seconds remaining.
Makes it third and 11.
Time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. And the Lombardi Trophy is going back home. The Green Bay Packers are your Super Bowl champions. And to the Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. It actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.
When now it's the word, I bring it back to paper.